Japanese airport in the national airspace system has distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas. From the flight deck. Charles M. Schulz Sonoma County Airport is a medium-sized airport that provides service to aircraft with a wide range of performance capabilities and a mix of air carrier, corporate, and general aviation. It is located northwest of the city of Santa Rosa, California. It's known for its intense firefighting aircraft activity during the fire season. The runway configuration consists of runway 1432, intersecting runway 220, and complex taxiway system.
Centurion 390 Quebec, Santa Rosa ground, taxi to the north ramp area via Alpha.
Hotspot 3 and 4 are located on the north side of the airport. A unique feature of Sonoma County Airport is that small piston aircraft taxiing for takeoff on runway 14 or runway 20 are issued a taxi clearance limit of the north run-up area by ground control and not the departure runway.
North run-up area via Alpha.
Informational signs in the run-up area instruct pilots to contact tower for runway assignment. The tower will normally issue runway 20 full length at taxiway hotel or runway 14 at taxiway Alpha 3. The issuance of runway and taxi instructions from the tower must be obtained prior to leaving the confines of the north run-up area. Turbine aircraft will normally be issued runway 14, taxi via Alpha, hold short of runway 20 approach, and switch to the tower abeam Alpha 3. Problems occur when pilots either do not understand their clearances and or are unsure of their position on the airport. For example, pilots, both piston and turbine, have been issued runway 14, taxi via Alpha, hold short runway 20 approach, and continued past the runway 20 approach hold, causing aircraft landing runway 20 to be sent around. Another variant of this issue occurs when pilots departing the north run-up are instructed, taxi up to and hold short runway 20 at hotel. They mistakenly make the slight right turn and taxi on Alpha across the runway 20 approach hold. The last issue with Hotspot 3 is that pilots have missed the north run-up area completely and continued on taxiway Alpha across the runway 20 approach hold. The results are all the same. Traffic on final for runway 20 is sent around. Strict compliance with taxi clearance and positive identification of aircraft position on the airfield will go a long way to eliminate these types of incidents.
Centurion 4600 Quebec, Santa Rosa Tower, runway 20, cleared for takeoff and left.
Hotspot 4 is the intersection of runway 1432 and runway 220. For various reasons, pilots have been cleared for takeoff on one runway, but have actually departed from the other. Improved signage and runway taxiway markings should help with this problem. Verifying runway and aircraft heading is the easiest way to avoid wrong runway usage. Pilots should always check their heading prior to starting departure roll.
Centurion 4639er Quebec, Santa Rosa ground, runway 32, taxi via Zulu Alpha.
Hotspot 1 is straightforward. The intersection of taxiway Alpha, Alpha 5, and Zulu can be confusing. Pilots taxiing from the ramp or southeast hangars need to be aware of their position and clearance to avoid mixing taxiway Alpha and taxiing onto runway 1432. Hotspot 2 is located at the south end of the airport and simply reminds pilots that a portion of the south run-up area is not visible from the tower. Pilots need to remember that if they are ever in doubt or unsure of any instruction or aircraft position, the easiest answer is to ask the tower. They are there to help. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at the Sonoma County Airport will help pilots make better decisions, and with the help of the Air Traffic Control Tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. Now you're better prepared for your trip to Charles M. Schulz Sonoma County Airport. It's always better to know before you go.